The International Space Station is arguably the most unique laboratory known to man, equipped with some of the most advanced equipment ever made. But perhaps its most exciting new piece of equipment? A novel 3D printer that uses resin and light to create near-perfect ceramic pieces in microgravity. This machine, created by Made in Space, is the beginning of what's being called space-enabled manufacturing. Made in Space is one of the driving forces in space manufacturing, and their ceramic printer is just the first in a line of three trailblazing facilities they plan to launch to the ISS.
One of the core values of Made in Space is to enable humans to live and work in the space environment. And that has a multitude of different angles. And one of those core premises is actually being able to develop products in the space environment to actually bring back down here to Earth to bring value.
The first one is going to be manufacturing ceramics on orbit. The second will be focused more on crystals. And the third will be actually casting superalloys, metallics.
This isn't Made in Space's first time printing in microgravity. In 2014, astronauts were able to 3D print the very first object in space, which led to establishing a permanent printing facility on the ISS called the Additive Manufacturing Facility, which has now printed more than 200 items for astronauts on board. The era of waiting months for a wrench is now behind them. So if the crew already has a printer, what's the big deal with these next generation printers?
The unique thing that we can do in space is we can take gravity out of the manufacturing equation. Everything that we make on the ground, everything we do from a processing perspective, that all has a uniform constraint, and that is 1G.
Gravity. Here on Earth, items made in our manufacturing facilities can have defects in the material, even microscopic ones, that can be caused by sedimentation or composition gradients, leading to shorter lifespans of the material. Instead of printing for just astronaut use, the MIS team would like to take advantage of the weightless environment to create materials that are stronger and more efficient than the ones made on Earth. The team plans to prove this with their first payload, the Ceramic Manufacturing Module, or CMM.
That machine is going to use stereolithography to be able to manufacture with some pre-polymer ceramic resin.
The CMM will start by working on printing single-piece blisks, which are bladed discs that are used in aircraft jet engines and other integrated rotors. Once printed, the pieces will be sent back to Earth to be heat-treated to form the final product of a ceramic matrix composite, or CMC. CMCs are immensely heat resistant and could perform hundreds of degrees hotter than the best superalloys. This makes them better than typical metal components like the ones used in aircraft engines.
High temperature, high pressure grade ceramics are something that is very coveted here on Earth.
Even minimal improvements to the materials, like resistance to high temperatures, can improve the fuel economy and efficiency. So right now for the CMM, Made in Space has two main objectives.
The first one is making sure the hardware works as we think it should in producing these items. The second one is taking these items that we produce, bringing them back down to Earth, analyzing them and comparing them to the ones that we produce on Earth to see if the differences are there and what those differences are.
While they're working on that, the next two payloads will be gearing up to go.
The next payload that we're going to be flying is the Industrial Crystallization Facility, or ICF. ICF is actually going to show that microgravity actually allows for the formation of solution-based crystals to grow much larger and actually be able to grow much more homogeneous than what you'd see here on Earth.
These crystals could be used to improve a variety of products, from high-efficiency ultraviolet light production to terahertz wave sensors.
And then the final payload that we're going to be sending up is actually very early next year, called Superalloy Casting Module. And this superalloy casting facility is taking a look at being able to heat treat, remelt, and solidify different materials on orbit, specifically high-grade temperature alloys. And that should result in actually reformulating the crystalline structure at its core level to be able to show why microgravity can help formalize and really make the inherent atomic structure more homogeneous.
So with the ceramics facility in place on the ISS and the printing innovations soon to follow, the team has high hopes that these machines will radically change the 3D printing industry. Proving these unique printers can build superior items in space could also help Made in Space's endeavor to build entire spacecrafts while in orbit. After all, the company already has plans to build the world's first self-building satellite, known as Archinaut 1. These space-enabled manufacturing concepts could forever change the way we look at how we live on Earth and how we could live in space. Ah, space. Just imagine how awesome it would be if you were able to travel to the ISS or even travel the solar system on a mission to explore the unknown. Sounds great as long as you had the right astronaut training, but what if you were a completely unprepared kid who accidentally got launched into space? Well, that's exactly what happens in Nickelodeon's brand new series, The Astronauts. This space adventure launches Friday, 11/13 with a 1-hour premiere event only on Nickelodeon. You don't want to miss it. For more rocket launches, check out our Countdown to Launch series here. And if there are any other launches that you want to see us cover, let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to Seeker, and thank you so much for watching.